Leeds began as a Saxon village. By the time of the Doomsday Book in 1086, it had a population of around 200. By the standards of the time, Leeds was quite a large village. Many were much smaller. Then, in 1207, the Lord of the Manor, Maurice de Gant, founded a new town at Leeds. At that time, trade and commerce were increasing in England, and many new towns were founded. By 1851, the population of Leeds had reached 101,000. Leeds grew rapidly, but many of the new houses built were dreadful. Overcrowding was rife, and streets were very dirty. As a result, there was a cholera epidemic in Leeds in 1832, which killed over 700 people. A second epidemic, in 1849, killed more than 2,000 people. In the 1850s, the council built sewers, but very many of the houses in Leeds were not connected to them. Many dwellings continued to use cesspits or buckets, which were emptied at night by the night soilmen. Not until 1899 was it made compulsory for dwellings in Leeds to be connected to the sewers. In 1901, the population of Leeds reached 178,000, and it continued to grow rapidly. In 1903, a statue of the Black Prince was erected in the city square. So were statues of eight nymphs. Leeds University was founded in 1904. Also that year, St. Anne's Roman Catholic Cathedral was built. Leeds City Market was also built in 1904, and the first cinema in Leeds was built in 1905. In the 1920s, the first council houses were built in Leeds. More were built in the 1930s. In 1925, St James Hospital was founded. In 1933, Leeds Civic Hall was built. During the Second World War, 77 people in Leeds were killed by bombs, and 197 buildings were destroyed. In the 20th century, the main industries in Leeds were engineering, such as making tram rails, and tailoring, with companies like Hepworth and Montague Burton. But during the century, the importance of the manufacturing industry declined. Instead, service industries grew rapidly. In 1951, 55% of the workforce were employed in manufacturing. By 1973, it had fallen to less than 35%. Many people in Leeds worked in banking, insurance, pubs, and hotels. take a look at this remarkable film of Bore Lane in the 1900s. Traffic Crossing Leeds Bridge in 1888, a film by Louis Le Prince. It was first licensed as the Turk's Head in 1715. Rebuilt by the Whitelock family in the 1800s, it later extended into a row of Georgian working men's cottages. John Betjeman described it as the very heart of Leeds. The City Varieties Music Hall. Harry Lauder, Charlie Chaplin and Houdini are just a few of the performers who performed in this music hall built in 1865 for Charles Thornton on the site of the White Swan Coaching Inn. It was the famous venue of the good old days, which was first broadcast in 1953.